If you're racist or a white supremacist, you might have heard of Twitter implementing a slight update into its Twitter rules that will most likely result in you being banned for life. And the new rule says that Twitter will monitor your activity outside of their platform to find out whether they should let you in or kick you out with a badge, neo-Nazi, free to punch.
Some kind of assembly?
Of course, this means that Twitter will spy on your browsing habits and possibly even all your telemetric data from your phone if you installed their app. So, even if you have never expressed your political opinions on Twitter, or even if you aren't really a neo-Nazi, a mere presumption based on the track record of your browsing history can be enough for this corporation to silence you for life. If this sounds ridiculous to you, check this justification they used for these Orwellian shenanigans. We believe in freedom of expression and open dialogue, but that means little as an underlying philosophy if voices are silenced because people are afraid to speak up, in order to ensure that people feel safe expressing diverse opinions and beliefs, we prohibit behavior that crosses the line into abuse, including behavior that harasses, intimidates, or uses fear to silence another user's voice. So in other words, to protect people who are afraid to speak up, Twitter will now make rules that will make you afraid to speak up. Twitter intentionally hides behind "we are against murder" narrative to make it appear like their new policy is a no-brainer. No bullying, threats, suicide, doxing, child abuse, sexual content, etc. But these are all cases where the law decides what's right or wrong, and the law enforcement goes after these people anyway. What Twitter wants to do, however, is purely political, as they reserve the right to define what's hurting other people's feelings and what isn't. I'm not saying a commercial service should be required to give everybody equal standing on their platform, but you as an internet citizen should know this is a dangerous precedent, setting us on a downhill path to an authoritarian dystopia run by tech corporations. When these platforms get so powerful and popular, they have essentially a monopoly on human communication and socialization. There is a lot at stake. Facebook is experimenting with democracy and people's emotions by tweaking their news feeds in certain ways to get specific effects they desire. Twitter will now witch hunt any dissenting opinion before it was even expressed by tracking your browsing history and mobile records. The narrative is going to be said by those who scream harassment the loudest.
Disgusting! Disgusting!
So while this will start affecting everyone on the right side of the political spectrum, this practice sets a precedence to go after you in the future, no matter what your beliefs are. Luckily for us, there are plenty of software developers who believe in freedom of the internet. They develop tools that help you take full control of your freedom and security. Using these tools, I'm going to teach you how to fight against this corporate governance and stop Twitter from tracking your online activity to censor you. There is one cybersecurity strategy that's especially effective when it comes to protecting your online freedoms and private life. If you do this right, Twitter will never be able to track your privacy and follow your identity. This process is known as compartmentalization, and it's an excellent security practice that separates access to sensitive information from open information. In this case, your sensitive information is your whole browsing history, and your open information is your activity on Twitter you're willing to share publicly. So you'll want to prevent Twitter from getting access to your browsing history. Insecurity by compartmentalization strategy. Each compartment has its own separate entry, completely independent from all other compartments. This is to make sure that even if an adversary breaks through one compartment, they still can't gain access to other compartments. For you, your compartments are going to be web browsers. You're going to have a separate web browser for Twitter and a separate one for everything else you do on the internet. While this creates two independent compartments, they are not completely separate from each other just yet. Websites can still track you across these two web browsers if they can plant trackers like cookies or cache on your device and connect the dots about your browsing habits by following your browser fingerprint. Your browsing fingerprint is a bunch of metadata that tell everything about you and the device you are connecting from. your battery life, screen resolution, hardware configuration like your CPU, number of cores of that processor, their frequency, your software configuration, your operating system, version of that system, your browser type, configuration, plugins and extensions, and your browsing history can all contribute to uniquely identifying you across all platforms on the internet. Together with your IP address, this will give a website an absolute certainty it is you, even if you are connecting from different browsers. Luckily, there is an easy way to shut all of these access points. I'll walk you through a very simple privacy configuration that will protect all of your online data forever. So let's start with the browsers. I said that you should have at least two, but they can't be just any browsers. It can't be Google Chrome, Safari, or Opera, because these can't be configured to protect your privacy enough. They always give away some of your private data, as that's how they make money off of you. If you already have a Twitter account, I suggest that you use Firefox and IceCat. These are both essentially the same, but IceCat comes hardened for privacy by default because it's made by the most paranoid and open source loving group of people in the world, the NU Foundation. Firefox is made by Mozilla and is much faster than IceCat, but some data are being sent to Mozilla Foundation by default. Fortunately, all of these can be turned off safely. Firefox is an open source software, so we can rely on the fact that you fully own and control your browser. If you turn something off, it's off, and not like on any of the deceptive Google services. To harden your browser for privacy, you are going to have to say goodbye to browsing history and cookies forever and start using bookmarks and pins to remember websites for later. So first, set your Firefox to never remember history. After you are done with that, go to the add-ins section and download and install these: uBlock Origin, Decentralize, Cookie Auto Delete, and HTTPS Everywhere. If you are willing to go even more hardcore to be absolutely safe, you can install uMetrix to block third-party requests, scripts, and all the tracking and malicious code on websites. Even if you are not logged into Twitter, websites you visit across the internet use social media plugins that track you everywhere. These usually come in the form of like and share buttons that you see on many articles. You have to block these to make sure Twitter isn't following you. And that's exactly what uMetrix is for. If you want to learn how to use uMetrix, you can check out my guide I made in my previous video. Link will be in the description. Also, I suggest that you go through these browser configurations step by step to hard code privacy into your Firefox. You can access these settings in the About Config tab and follow this guide on the privacytools.io to know what to turn on and off. Once you've done this, you can now choose which browser will be for your Twitter and which one for everything else. I would suggest to use IceCat for Twitter because it's already privacy configured and Twitter is a static website, so you will not need the speed of Firefox. Because Firefox is so fast with its quantum update released in November, I would use it for general browsing. Other habit you should learn is to close your browser to end browsing session and let it delete all the tracking cache and cookies. Don't spend too much time browsing the web on the same session. After you browse the web for work-related stuff, close it and restart it to have a separate session for relax and entertainment-related activities. What's great about this compartmentalization is that you can use and really should do this for every website where you have your online accounts, even for Facebook or your email accounts. You don't have to have separate browsers for each of them, but you can easily add Brave Browser as another privacy compartment. It's also up to you which compartment you decide to use for what browsing activity, but once you do it, you should never interchange them. Use only one browser for Twitter and Facebook, another one for emails, banking and other serious accounts, and a third browser for general browsing. And keep it like that forever. The only connecting dot that remains open is your IP address. If you want to create a new account, you can do this over Tor. Tor is a hidden anonymity network and it is the best browser for privacy. However, because it's so secure and untraceable, a little bit of speed had to be sacrificed and I don't want you to be put off by inconvenience and not protect your privacy at all. So that's why I told you this privacy configuration using Firefox, IceCat and Brave. You can create a completely anonymous Twitter account over Tor without giving Tor any personal details. If they ask you for a phone number, just give them a burner phone, which is essentially a prepaid SIM card that you paid for by cash. Your unique IP address could be helpful for Twitter to identify you, but if you block all the trackers and scripts properly in all your compartmented browsers, through the hardest way I mentioned here, that is with the Umetrix add-in, it will be impossible for Twitter to track you continuously. But there could be cases where your user error and bad operation security could reveal your privacy to Twitter, and they could get a lead by following your IP address. And by they, I mean their self-learning algorithms. Tor browser hides your IP address perfectly, but you have to be careful. If you use accounts with your real identity, Tor can't protect you from other websites tracking you through that identity. So to use Tor properly, learn to close it after you are done with your Twitter or other accounts, and start a new session so that all Twitter and Facebook trackers are deleted before you do other browsing. This way, you are creating compartments on the same browser, which is only safe using Tor, because each new session on Tor has its own identity and they can never be linked together. The only problem is that you can't be logged into your Twitter while doing browsing on Tor at the same time. You have to close it and restart it to have separate compartments. So if you don't want to use Tor, VPN is your only option to protect your privacy compartments. But be careful, never trust a free VPN. Maintaining a virtual private network is expensive, and free VPNs sell your browsing history to advertisers to cover the costs. Get educated about which VPN to use by following guides on VPN subreddit and that1privacysite.net. Always look for a VPN that's outside of the Five Eyes countries, especially the US and the UK, has strong no-locks policy, and other privacy benefits. You are responsible to do your own research, but if you want some names to start with and do some benchmarks, check out AzireVPN, BlackVPN, BolehVPN, NordVPN, Mullvad, Trust.zone, and Proxy.sh. And one last thing, what about your phone? My suggestion would be not to use the Twitter app. An app in your phone can potentially spy on all the content and data you generate while using it, including your physical location, real-world movement, your mobile payments, and contents of your storage like photos, documents, and videos. If you want to access your online accounts on your phone, also do it through Tor. For Android, you can download or web to configure your connection to be routed through the Tor network, and then use Orfox web browser to access websites anonymously. I think that a message that's important has to be delivered through the mainstream. We can't be hiding on alternative platforms to safely voice our opinions in echo chambers, until we get decentralized platforms where no single organization is in full control. We have to continue our struggle for freedom and privacy, where everybody has their eyes and ears. Nobody should be marginalized because they're there to have non-violent opinions that some people don't like. Freedom of speech and privacy are more important than whatever convenience all of these corporations offer. I hope this tutorial helped you protect your identity from Twitter and other corporate social networks. Thank you very much for watching. If you found this video useful, please share it with your friends who you think might also need this help. Feel free to ask me any questions in the comments regarding your cybersecurity and online freedom. Subscribe if you are new here, and see you next time.